गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट टेबल्स इन एमएस वर्ड 2007। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल ओपन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस वर्ड 2007। सो आई एम क्लिकिंग ऑन स्टार्ट, देन वी विल कम स्क्रॉल डाउन, वी विल गेट माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस। क्लिक ऑन माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस, देन वी विल हैव माइक्रोसॉफ्ट ऑफिस वर्ड 2007। Click on Microsoft Office Word 2007 and Microsoft Office Word 2007 will be opened. Now in the page book we will open the page number 47 and try to do the exercise practical in computer lab. So this window is opened. We will click on maximize button to maximize the screen. The exercise says we have to create a table with 6 rows, 3 columns using insert table option. So as mentioned in the video, we will click on insert. Then in the table insert we have table option, we will click on table. Then we will come to insert table option and it says we have 6 rows and 3 columns. So number of columns are 3, so we will click on 3, and number of rows are 6, so we will click on 6. We will type 6. And then we will click on OK. We will see that the table is created, and when this table is created of 6 rows and 3 columns, automatically this design and layout tab are shown. Now this is one way of creating a table. We will also learn one more way of creating a table. So I am just pressing Ctrl Z to undo. Now again I want to insert a table, so we will click on insert, we will click on table. Now this grid is shown. Now it says we have to have 6 rows and 3 columns. So what I will do, I will position my pointer on this grid. I will select 6 rows. I am just moving the pointer on the grid. I am not pressing the left mouse button. Then I want 3 columns. So I will just drag it. You can see we have 6 rows and 3 columns, and here I will click. So 6 rows and 3 columns are created. So there are two ways in which I can create the table. The first one as explained to you in the video, and second is we will just drag the pointer over the grid and the table will be created. Now I want to increase the size of the table. So here we have this button, this is small square at the bottom right corner. This is known as a table resize handle. Now when I click my pointer, it will take a double headed arrow. I will press my left mouse button and I will drag. The size of the table will be increased. Now here this is table resize handle at the bottom right corner, and at the top left corner this is table move handle. Now this is a plus of a different style. If I click, the whole table will be selected. So my home table is selected. I will go to home. I will increase the size. When the whole table is selected, I can change the font. I can make the text bold, italic or underline, or even I can change the color. So I want the headings. So what I will do is, we have only increased the size. Now what I will do, I will click in the blank area, the table is unselected. Now the exercise says type the headings in columns, roll number, name and class. So I want to select the first row, so I will position the pointer at the left corner where the first row is starting, and it takes a shape of an arrow. When I click, only the first row is selected. Now I will give it a center align because I want the text to be aligned in center. I will take the text as color as maroon, and here I am here in the first cell, and we will type roll number. Then next column we have to type the name. So we will click here and we will type the name. Then in the next column we have to type the class, so we will just type the class. So this heading is typed, center align. Now in the remaining I have to type the data of 5 students in your class. You can also do that. Now see, when I have to move to the next cell, I press the tab key. Tab key takes me to the next cell. But if I press shift plus tab, shift plus tab takes me to the previous cell. Tab key takes me to the next cell, and shift plus tab takes me to the previous cell. So data you can type on your own. Now I have to insert a column to the right and put the headings as marks. So what I will do is, one method is explained to you in your video, there is another method. I will position the pointer at the last column and the shape of the arrow is changed. I will click on this column, the whole of the column is selected. Now what I will do is, I will go to layout, and in layout there is insert left and insert right. So if I click on insert right, a column is inserted on the right. So this way I will insert the column in the right. I will click here and I will give the heading as, just see the home tab, is it, the formatting is the same. So what I will do is, I will give the heading as marks, and the data you can type on your own. For typing the data, you can change the color to black, you can change the color to automatic, and the remaining data will be coming as black. So this exercise you have to do in your computer as a practice exercise for tables. Another exercise which you have to do, which we haven't done of last chapter, is on page number 36, where it says insert the following currency symbols, euro, pound and yen. We have already learned how to insert the symbols, so we will be able to do it. The next is, we have to draw certain shapes. So I will be coming on to insert. I will put the pointer here at the last. Then I will go on pressing enter, control Z, I don't want that. I will put the pointer here last and enter. Okay, I will put the pointer at the bottom. Now I will press enter, it will come here. Now I want to insert certain shapes, so I will go to insert. We will go to shapes. The first shape is, is a rectangle of a certain type, so we will just search for that rectangle shape. Yeah. I think it is this. So we will click here. Let's take it this. Okay, and you might take a different shape also. We have taken this. Then after that it says star. It says for fill in the color. Fill in the color will be red. So we will click on the format menu and we will get the red color or whatever. If I am not getting the red color, I will come to shape fill, and from shape fill I will select the color as red. Now after that we have to draw the star, so I will go to insert, shapes is open here. I will go to shapes, we will select a star, say this is the star, and we will draw the star. We can increase the size right now. Then we will fill the color. It says green color, green color is shown here, so I am filling the color as green. Now shape outline is no color, so no outline, it is no outline. Then, or we can say shape outline is of black color, so it is black color. Then I have to fill the smiley, so again I will click here down. I will get the smiley, this is the smiley, and I will put the smiley down here. And we will put it in a yellow color. So yellow color is not here, so we will go to shape fill and we will fill with yellow color. Now all my three shapes are there. I have to group them together. So first shape is selected, I will press control and I will select the second shape, then I will select the third shape. Now right click and grouping and group. So it will be grouped as one. I can copy it and paste it, copy. And then if I paste it, I will get another shape over. So this way I can treat it as a group. This is the exercise you have to do. So both these exercises you should practice in your computer. Thank you for today's class.